If you find the content relevant, then do like, share and subscribe to the channel. Also hit the bell button to get a regular notification. Also do share your experiences and any suggestions that you have in the comment box. Hope you enjoyed.
Hi, so we're looking at CAT 2020, just got over. So we're looking at expected percentiles at different scores. So let's try to understand the paper pattern and then come up to the expected percentiles for different scores. So CAT 20, 26 VRC questions with 18 RCs, 3 para jumbles, 3 para summary, and 2 odd man out. 24 questions of DLR, 2 6 questions each and 3 4 questions, and 26 questions of quant. So what made CAT 20 different? Two things. One is there were less time per question. So that means if you look at CAT 19, it was almost 1.8 minutes per question. 100 questions, 180 minutes. And CAT 20, there was 1.57 minutes per question. So reduction of time, which was huge. Also, the questions in each section were tougher than CAT 19. So since the questions were tougher and less time per question, made it a little more complicated in terms of the overall scheme of things. So yes, the cutoffs are expected to come down for CAT 20. So just listed down what is the tentative marks and the percentile. So you have a fair idea about it. Scores could be down or up to some extent, but this is approximately. So around 40 to 43 marks is what I'm expecting, 99.5 percentile. VRC was very vague this time. A little tough in a sense, people were not able to understand the passage and the questions. So yes, so 36 to 39 marks was 99 percentile and so on. So you have, you know, different marks and different percentiles. So you can look at what is the expected score and what is the percentile. Approximately, it will remain the same, a little bit up and down here and there. But yes, wait for your final scores and the final mark sheet to, and then you can compare with this, right? So this is based on the fact of last year's percentile marks and then a little lower than that purely because the paper was tough. So if you are scoring a 20 to 23 marks, which will be 90 percentile. For 20 minutes, approximately 7 questions completely correct without any mistakes, 100% accuracy will give you a 90 percentile score. Right? Same bit. Around 12 to 13 questions completely correct without any mistakes would give you a 99 percentile. So this is where the tentative scores comes for VRC. Coming to DILR, 99.5 percentile is 34 to 37. It was, I'm not saying all sets were tough. There were a couple of easy sets which you could have picked up and solved. But to score very high would be difficult. Yes, so that means if I have scored 12 questions correct, so 99.5 percentile is where I can expect. Okay, 12 complete correct questions is possible. For 90 percentile, maybe around 6 questions correct completely, full accuracy could give you a 90 percentile. So the tentative marks of how much you need to score per section to get your marks in place. Coming to quant, around 16 questions completely correct would have given you 99.5 percentile. And similarly, if you look at it, around 7 to 8 questions completely correct would give you a 90 percentile. So tentative marks, you can see your marks, you can see the corresponding percentile. This is just to make you understand where you stand and what is the corresponding cutoffs. If you look at the overall, because this is the tentative overall scores. So that means if you're anywhere expecting 60 marks, a 90 percentile is possible. Less than 100, 99 percentile is possible, right? So the cutoffs should be lower this year. Normally what happens is when the paper is really tough, people do panic in the exam and the marks goes down drastically. So this will give you a fair idea in terms of what is the marks for different percentiles that you can score to get your percentiles. I hope that is clear with it, okay? So analyze this, look at it, gives you a fair idea. I mean, you will have to still wait for your mark sheet to come. You'll have to still wait for the actual percentile to come. But this may give you a fair idea as to where you stand with the overall scheme of things. So it may help you to apply to different colleges, whichever you want to. Based on your last year's cutoff and this year's percentile, you can apply accordingly. Hope that helps. Thank you.